I'm getting a little homage to Wrecking Crew, which was for the NES, and Streets of Rage for the Genesis when I take a look at the cityscape background. But then again, Wrecking Crew didn't ever have a background, did it? Somebody really needs to remake that game, I stress. I mean, Wrecking Crew is a good game for the NES. Pardon me for going off into a tangent on this, but it was fun, you could break walls and whatnot, it was lovely. And now, a zone that was actually made by level designers, the actual original team. It's Hidden Palace Zone. And I will get more into Hidden Palace Zone as I complete the game. But all you need to know for now is that there was originally a Miles map in there. And the Batbot. Remember how Sonic 1 had a Batbot that just flew whenever it was near you? Well, each Batbot in every Sonic game does this. That enemy is not seen for the rest of the game, and this jump. Only a very precise jump can get through here as Sonic. If you fall through the side, it's an instant kill. This also happens in the Simon Y demo, which I'll show off later on, after I'm done with Super Donkey Kong Country and Super Back to the Future 2, obviously. This time the Batbot actually goes in a U pattern. It'll go to the side and then it'll go back to where you were. And yeah. Loving the little lighting system there. And the Master Emerald. Remember how I said that the Master Emerald was vital to the series? You learn more about it in Sonic 3, but apparently in this game, there is a serious purpose for the Master Emerald. In later revisions of this title, this Master Emerald piece is just a breakable jewel that you could destroy. And dinosaur anime, basically, I don't know what the Dinobot's there for. I'm figuring he has the same move scheme as Motobug and using single frame step motion in action. Yeah, literally if you could spin dash through that, you can literally just go down this pipe which leads to nothing. But if you go into debug mode and head left, there's actually some platforms here. Sadly though, you can't actually head back up without going into debug mode, and for convenience sake, I actually am going to drown here. So, yeah. Sorry, Sonic, but you have to drown. I'm sorry. This map has a better design this time around, thank god. But nevertheless, we're restarting the level, and it's all honky-dory, I guess. Too many rings. This is like one of those only games, or at least one of those only Sonic 2 stages that feature too many rings. I mean, you can get at least 50 rings within the first 10 seconds of the stage. Don't you think that's a bit odd to you? I mean, there is literally no Sonic game that features 50 rings right off the bat. Okay, Sonic Unleashed Skyscraper Scamper Act 3. That's the only other time that you can get 10 rings at the beginning. I mean, 50 rings at the beginning, but still. That's a game for another time. God, that background's awesome. And respawning enemies? What? Yeah, this game is popular for respawning enemies in Hidden Palace Zone. Only Hidden Palace Zone does this. This I question a various lot. Why would they do that? Why would they have it so that they have respawning enemies in the game? There's no reason to have enemies that respawn anywhere. Especially if it's, I mean, think of it. In Mega Man, it made sense if enemies had respawned only because, well, you went off screen and then Wily was able to repair some robots and have them come back. But this game has no excuse. They shouldn't have robots in the background die and then come back to life. they didn't die, they died originally, so why are they coming back? Sonic Blast is really the only game that features respawning enemies. Aside from a title such as Sonic Labyrinth, and I've heard that many people hate Sonic Labyrinth, but whatever, and Drowning in the Air, hello? Nah, that's a glitch that's seen in later games, especially titles such as, which one was it? Oh, now you get to hear Labyrinth Zone's music. Lost my train of thought there. But yeah, I don't really know any other games aside from Blast and Labyrinth that featured respawning enemies. If there is another one in the series, it's... Tales of Venture, that's what I was thinking of, sorry. But yeah... Barely any 16-bit games featured respawning enemies. And trust me, if each game did have respawning enemies, then, it definitely would be seriously annoying, and... Sonic's dancing. Sonic's dancing to Labyrinth. Oh god. Sonic can kick anus on the dance floor, or the dance monitor in this case? Now that is awesome. Oh, Sonic, you tend to make me happy in some of the oddest ways. By the way, did anybody notice that Triforce symbol in the background? That's good. Now time to go to the Labyrinth Zone, which literally is a labyrinth this time. Oh god. You have to find your way to the end due to means of invisible platforms. No, not really. This is just a glitch up level, which is still based off of Labyrinth Zone. The reason why the background's so wavy is because of the water effect and... Good god, this area doesn't know how to control itself. What is wrong with this stage? No! I've never seen this stage get that bad. But of course, you can in fact, there are in fact a few save states, which I do own, which are from the Sonic 2 beta page. Well, not really, I can't really say that I own them personally. I do have the save states saved. Let's just say that, because nobody owns save states. Pardon me. But yeah, these save states actually give you some kind of level layout, which you can use in order to get through the stage properly. This came in handy and... Yeah, Emerald Hill was originally labeled as Starlight Zone Act 3. That's why you might have a little bit of a... kind of a nice feel to it. You might also notice that the clouds somewhat move by themselves. Sort of. I haven't been able to find more than these rings at the very beginning in terms of Act 3 of Starlight Zone. I mean, this is just this is just Act 1 with only a few rings and no enemies, so it is... Oh yeah, and no traps, so there's no real benefit to playing this stage, only if you're bored and you want to test out the stage with nothing in it. Makes good practice if you're trying to speedrun the entire stage, well, not speedrun the stage, but at least teach yourself to speedrun the stage. And I tried to see if I could jump off the wall and land on the platform, but no, I can't. Can't really do anything with that spin dash, good god. Oh yeah, and funny thing. So, this actually does happen if you hack Sonic the Hedgehog with the S-Rail Sonic Editor. If you hack the first Sonic the Hedgehog using the S-Rail Sonic Editor, you actually can run through the end of the loop. Which really is tedious. S-Rail from Sonic Retro, if you ever see this video, I question, why is this glitch a part of your Sonic Editor for Sonic 1? I could not for the life of me figure out why this glitch is existent, and... What's this?